Hi. Miss Carter?
Uh-huh.
Hi.
Hi.
I'm Jim Patton.
Hi, Mr. Patton.
Waco Education Foundation.
Okay.
And you wrote a grant.
Oh, my gosh.
And we selected you.
Why don't you
come on in, guys. You wrote a grant for math activities, and we've given you a grant in the amount of roughly $6,900. So tell us, what are you going to do with the grant? What were some of the fun things that you had planned?
Well, I'm going to follow through with some research that I found that says that math games are the best way to get kids to learn some foundations of math. And we're going to be ordering dice. And there's like 5 books on my list that has hundreds of games. We're going to be ordering cards. We're going to be ordering the manipulatives, 30-sided dice, 10-sided dice, everything these kids know to become masters of math. I love math.
That is a fantastic, fantastic grant. Boys and girls, give your teacher a hand. All right. Well, congratulations so very much. Hi. I'm Jim Patton. I'm with Education Foundation. You wrote a grant to the Education Foundation, and we would like to fund it for an aquaponics lab. Am I correct?
Yes, correct.
Can you tell us about it?
Sure. It's a system that uses... I'm a little excited. Guys, what I was talking about a long time ago, y'all remember? We were riding on the board. It uses fish and water, and it grows vegetables and plants. Yeah, you remember?
Yeah.
We got it. We're going to do it.
Yeah.
In the amount of $4,668. We look forward to coming back and seeing it once you got it going.
Yeah, it's so exciting.
Congratulations, man.
Thank you, so much.
Thank you for writing such a good grant.
Thank you.
And being a great support with Waco ISD.
Man, thank you so much.
Ms. Childress.
Oh, hi.
Hi. Excuse me, guys. I'm with Education Foundation. I'm Jim Patton.
Hi.
And we are here to present to you a $5,000 check. For designing lions. So can you tell us what your plans are with this grant?
Yeah, absolutely. We are planning on creating a costume and makeup lab that can be used for productions and for in-class projects and things like that, so that we can go from having costumes built to our students actually building the costumes for our shows. So we're really excited about it.
So you'll be using this by your next musical?
Yes, definitely. We'll definitely put it to use for Little Mermaid.
Little Mermaid is the next musical. That's awesome. Well, it was a well-written grant, and we are thrilled to be able to give you this grant. And this is also a grant that was named through Dupuy Oxygen.
Oh, fantastic.
They were unable to be here with us today, but they also wanted to extend their congratulations.
Wonderful. We love the Dupuis. They are always very supportive of us.
Absolutely. All right, boys and girls, what do you think? I'm Jim Patton with Education Foundation Board, and we are here to present you a check for $3,000.
Awesome. Oh, you got all the kids. Fantastic.
They're coming in. This is also a named grant for Rondi and Sandy Gray.
Oh, wonderful.
And they are Waco alums.
Thank you so much. We sure appreciate it. This
65 years ago.
Oh, wow. Fantastic. Great. Well, thank you so much. We really appreciate this. This makes this program really, really work. Otherwise, it's very different from the two sides of this exchange. The Germans come and... Hello, everybody. Hi, students. Hi. Oh, wow. Hi.
We're trying to get over here behind you.
Sure. Sorry about this. I got kind of an electrical situation.
So we can give you the literal information so you know what to do.
Fantastic.
And this is also for your door.
Oh, wonderful. Okay.
So tell us what the funding is going to help do.
So this funding helps us sort of, it helps us equalize with our German partners. They come here and they experience the culture of Waco, and they live with these guys, in case y'all didn't know that. Okay, German students individually come. This is our 30th year of this exchange. And rather than spending the year selling candy and doing that sort of thing, these guys work hard to learn German, and they put up Germans in their own homes and take them places. The school, excuse me, I'm a little nervous here. We go and the school district helps them a little bit in that we provide those German guys some buses to do outings. But then at the end of their exchange, or sometimes in the middle, but usually at the end, they go to San Antonio and they soak up the culture in San Antonio down there. They visit the missions. They go to the international school they visited and the Museum of Texan Cultures and those sorts of things. And so we wanted to do something like that. And so then the second time I did this exchange in 2010, you guys came up with some money to help us out, and we got to go to a youth hostel in Duisburg. And it really changes the experience a little bit. We get to say thank you guys to the Germans, and then we go off on our own and experience some of Germany on our own, sort of without the help from those families. Of course, they're there in case something happens, like we're there for the Germans. But 21 Germans came this year, which is, as far as I know from looking back at the data, the most that have ever come, and it's great because it's our 30th year. And those guys had a blast. Our families were terrific. Our kids were terrific. They, our pairings were pretty good. Almost everybody got along great. You can imagine 42 teenagers paired up can sometimes be tricky. And they just really, really had a good time. Baylor University helped host them to a tour of the stadium. And our relationship with Baylor continues to grow in the German and the other foreign languages. And I just think it's wonderful that we're going to be able to use this money to help the kids travel in town, actually in and out of Cologne, or where we stay is near the big city of Cologne in the western side of Germany. And we go through the cathedral. Hopefully we'll get to do a tour. I've only got to do it twice with students, which is up underneath the roof and the rafters, so that you're up in the cathedral looking down into the
sanctuary.
Just thank you very much. Into the sanctuary there. And
I'm paying attention.
And this is, yeah. And it just gives us this opportunity. Our hope right now is that we'll either go to Bremen and then up to Bremerhaven. And then there's maybe an opportunity. I don't think the parents and kids know this. Possibly we'll go to Hamburg instead, which is a place I've never been. But some of the German teachers really recommended us to go to Hamburg. But both of those are in the northern part of Germany. And so like 2-3 nights in a hostel with 21 kids, and then touring and going to, and going to these sorts of places. These guys, without this money, let me explain it this way. Without this money, we go to school. I don't know if I mentioned that. We would go to school. They would take lessons in the German school and do outings with their families, and that would be it. Absolutely it, which would be great. The first year we did it, that was fine, but it's nothing really like the other side of this exchange. And to be able to do so much with this much, I mean, this is a fantastic amount, but we really put it to good use. That's what I'm saying. These guys, we go all over at the end, and it just really makes it different. I was really hoping for this one, so I'm really, really nervous.
We're happy to support you guys and look forward to hearing back a great report from the trip.
Absolutely, absolutely. We will report.
Congratulations.
And enduring with the new technology, these guys.
That's true.
They can tell you what's going on sort of during. We'll give you a weekly report.
All right, maybe send us some schnitzel.
That doesn't pack well.
Oh, Madeline. Yeah. Thank you so much.
Thank you, we sure appreciate it.
Hi, Miss Gifford. Come on over.
Hi.
How are you?
I'm good.
I'm Jim Patton with the Education Foundation, and we have a grant for you in the amount of $4,010 for your ELL success program. Dudley Haas is the named grant.
You're welcome. We needed this. Thank you so much.
So tell us what you're going to do with this.
We have in-school tutoring, GCS lab, and we need to have something more for our ELL speakers. We are getting so many new to Waco ISD in high school that just don't know English. And so our hope is to get a lab going to give them more support. Wow. So this is very much needed. Thank you.
Well, we're thrilled, and we hope great success. Mr. Haas, thank you. You are such a supporter of Waco ISD, and you're out and about.
It's a great cause. Yes.
You have anything you want to say?
No, I just, congratulations. I'm glad that you won it, and we hope to do it each year.
Awesome. You'll get information on how to... Oh, there's Dr. Kane.
Oh, thank you.
And this is for either outside your office or outside the administrative suite, whatever Mr. Love says.
Yes, yes. Thank you. All right, I appreciate this. Thank you so much.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Oh, my gosh. Hold on, let me get my sweater on.
Hi, I'm Jim Patton with Education Foundation Board.
Awesome.
You wrote a grant.
Yay!
I believe it was for graphic novels.
Yes.
And we funded you $6,991.
Awesome.
Congratulations.
Yay.
Tell us what you're going to do.
Oh, my goodness. I don't even know where to begin. We are going to buy more graphic novels. We've already started. We've got some money from our PTA, who has given us $2,000, and we've started that collection, and I cannot keep those on the shelves. I can hardly even get them on the shelves. I just keep them on the cart. So we're really excited about that. And
tell us what a graphic novel is.
Well, a graphic novel is, it could be a comic book, or it could be an actual novel, and they are... they have a lot of pictures, and they have the little word bubbles and whatnot, but they really help expand their verbiage. So they can read higher level words and a higher level reading because they can interpret what's going on through the pictures. So it really gets them out of their reading level, and maybe they can read higher level reading and get it into their hands because it's a high interest.
Wow, that's fantastic. How long have you been here with Tennyson?
Just this year, since September.
Wow, and making changes like this. This is awesome.
Yeah.
Congratulations. We're excited, and we look forward to coming back a little bit later on in the year and seeing what you're doing.
Yeah, absolutely.
Thank you, guys.
And let me give, this is the lady that had, I just am so thankful that I have a principal, and this is, I can't accept this without bringing her in because this is a team effort. And then Flinchy, did I see Flinchy? Come here, Flinchy. Let's get a picture because... this is not just me. This is a team effort between Ms. Hall and Flinchy. And from the first day I walked in, even in my interview, you talked about how important it was and that you wanted somebody in the library to get the, put the books off the shelf, and you said that, you know, they were old and outdated and we wanted to get books in kids' hands. And so this is absolutely a team effort. This is not something I'm doing on my own. Absolutely. So I can give them the credit as well.
Okay, I'll take it. No, I'm just kidding. No, but the creativity that's here, like even just like this little thing right here for Poetry Month, I mean, it's just constant. The kids love to come in here. Like they, and you don't see that a lot of times with middle school students, and they want to be in this library. We've had more checking out of books this year than we have in the last several years. AR tests, just everything. It's just up, up, up.
Well, this is one of Sanderson Farms named grants for you guys. So when you get your information, you guys might want to send a thank you.
Eat more chicken.
Absolutely. But they were kind enough to support us, and this is going to help you guys.
Oh,
it's going to be exciting.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Awesome.
Sean Knuckles, Mr. Knuckles. I'm Jim Patton with Waco Education Foundation Board.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you. You wrote a grant?
Yes.
For bowls, for art?
Correct.
And we have funded your grant.
Awesome.
For $6,784.
Awesome. Thank you guys.
Can you tell us what you're going to do?
We're going to buy a kiln and start a ceramic program so the kids can work in clay.
Awesome. This is Taylor Bledsoe. He's with Sturdy Steel.
How are you? Nice to meet you.
And they are the named grant. And they are big, big backers for Waco ISD. You want to say a few words?
Yeah, we're just very thankful to be able to do this. I'm a WISD graduate along with my sister, and so is my mom. We're very passionate about the district, and we're just very thankful that the Education Foundation gives us the opportunity to give back. And so congratulations. We're excited about being a part of it.
Thank you. All right, Ms. Nelson, we'd like to present a grant to you from Education Foundation for $44.47.95. Can you tell us what you're going to do with this grant?
Yes, we are going to get lighting in our auditorium area so that we can do better musicals. We got our sound last year, so we're super excited about this.
And what's the next musical you're going to do?
Well, we haven't announced it, so I'm not going to let you know yet.
Keep us waiting. Very well, very good. Well, this is a named grant, and Gold Star Transit and David Gray helped provide the funding for this grant, and big supporters of the school. And Mr. Gray, do you have a few words you'd like to say?
Well, I'd just like to thank you for the opportunity to participate. I don't know if anybody in the room recognized me. You may see me in the mornings and sometimes in the afternoons. Anybody on a school bus?
Yeah.
So I just like the opportunity to participate in so many different levels. This is just a fantastic thing. I had my time in drama in junior high and high school where I went to school, and getting an opportunity to give something back, I just love it.
Well, thank you so much. We really appreciate it.
And we're thrilled that you wrote the grant. We also have Director of Fine Arts, Mr. Carpenter. Woo-hoo! You have something to say about grants with fine arts?
I am very proud of all my fine arts folks, but especially these guys, because they've been putting some good things on the stage here lately, and it's great that the foundation sees the value in what they're doing and willing to support that to bump up the quality of the technical side of the great acting that we've got going on. Ms. Nelson, she's doing a great job.
So you're going to be buying lighting and sound equipment?
Yes, and we actually, Corey Garrett over at Waco High, he suggested the perfect sound system and lighting system for us, so he has helped us in that way, so we're pretty excited.
So no hints on what the musical is going to be?
No hints.
There will be music.
Yes. It might be Christmassy.
Oh, awesome. Maybe. Awesome. Well, I look forward to seeing it.
Okay.
Congratulations once again.
Well, thank you so much.
Ms. Sykes?
Hey.
Hi, I'm Jim Patton. I'm with Education Foundation.
That's exactly who you are. Oh, yes. Hi.
Congratulations.
We'd like to say congratulations on a $7,500
for NCI. Oh, yes. Thank you.
Tell us what NCI is.
NCI is an outdoor education program that I try very hard to take all of my seventh graders to. It is every discipline. It is every discipline: math, science, social studies, English, PE, art, theater, everything built into a three-day outdoor education where they camp out in monolith domes and they study how to be ecologically smart in nature. They study meals and how we can keep waste away from meals. And I've been doing it for a couple of years, and it is such an important thing to these students. Ask any eighth grader who went as a seventh grader about NCI, and let them tell you how wonderful it is and how they still think about it and talk about it.
Wow.
And I can't thank you enough, because what this does is this gets more children who might not be able to afford it. It discounts their price, and we can get there. We can take every single one of them now. Thank you.
Oh, that's fantastic. The foundation is thrilled to be able to support this project. Mr. Sykes, do you have anything you would like to say to your wife?
Thanks, Jim.
He's never been, but maybe he needs to go
I need to participate. Mrs. Sykes, congratulations to you.
Thank you, sir.
And this is an awesome grant, and we know it will be used well. And
absolutely.
Here's a little banner for you to put up in the classroom.
Absolutely.
All right. Congratulations.
Thanks.
Congratulations.
Oh, thanks. Oh, wonderful. Thank you so much.
And
Thank you.
And Coca-Cola is the named grant for this grant. And Rhonda Donahue is here.
I know you.
And Rhonda has and Coca-Cola have been great partners, especially at Tennyson, for a number of years. You want to say
a few
words?
I've been around here a while. So have you.
Yes, I've been here for a lot of years. Yes, ma'am, I have. And Coca-Cola is very proud to be a part of the Waco Education Foundation, Tennyson. We enjoy helping teach the learners of today and the leaders of tomorrow.
Mr. Ubrey. Hi, I'm Jim Patton with Education Foundation. How are you, sir?
Good, real good now.
We're here to present you a grant for $1,900.
Wow.
You wrote a grant entitled Slumdog Superstars. Can you tell us about it?
Well, it's a math program and reading program that motivates the students. They answer math questions, and they compete against schools all over the country. Right now, we're in the middle of a competition. You can see on the board, we are winning for McLennan County right now. And we have the number one student, and we're competing against all the local districts. So it's a big deal. The kids love it. Class.
Yes.
What do you guys think about Some Dog?
We love Some Dog!
Well, we are thrilled to be able to
help
you guys continue in this and look forward to good scores and happy children.
Yeah, they're working hard.
Hi.
Wow, balloons and everything.
Hi.
Oh, my goodness. It's not my birthday today.
Ms. Alanis?
Yes?
I am Mr. Patton with Education Foundation Board.
Nice to meet you.
And you, excuse me, Mija, you had written a grant, and we are funding you in the amount of $3,472 and some change.
I'm so excited. Thank you very much.
And this is for books, I believe.
Yes, it is.
Could you tell us a little bit more about it?
Yeah, well, in pre-K, our kids still don't go to the library, so they cannot take books home from the library. So we needed to have our own library so we can send books home, so parents can read the same books that we read here at school. And it's a very, very important for them because we are developing their vocabulary and their reading comprehension. And if they read more every day, they're gonna increase that and they're gonna be more successful when they, go to kindergarten and during their whole school life. So I'm so happy for them. They are so excited to read and to learn. And most of all, there's gonna be a lot of kids. Now we have 5 pre-K classroom in our school. So more than 100 kids will be benefit from this. So thank you very much for make this possible.
And this grant is given in behalf of Ratliff Ready Mix Manufacturing, and they're one of Waco ISD supporters. And so they couldn't be with us today, but want to be sure and say congratulations to you. Miss Forbes. Hi.
Surprise.
I'm Jim Patton with Waco Education Foundation. And we have a grant for you. in the amount of $1,646.
I'm so excited.
Now tell me, you're the music teacher here, is that
yes,
correct?
Sir.
And what are you going to use this grant
for? With this grant, y'all were so kind, I got a grant last year that helped me with the multicultural. So this
yes,
is
ma'am.
Going to help with the literacy aspect. And I'm going to be reinforcing literacy concepts in my room with adding music to books that the students are reading. So
that's it. That's innovative.
Yes.
That's awesome.
So
congratulations. Yeah. Mr. Carpenter? Director of Fine Arts, what would you have to say about this?
I think Katie Forbes is phenomenal, and I appreciate so much she's written this grant. She is such an excellent teacher about cross-curricular and wants to make sure the kids are learning not only her content area, but across the board. And so we're just so appreciative to have her in the department and here at Providence Heights. I'm excited. I'm very excited.
It's a great place to be.
Ms. Sims, Debbie Sims, principal of Providence Heights.
Ms. Forbes is awesome. She actually has drove me crazy on the grant last year. She's wanted it, and we brainstormed, and she's asked for additional things that we went to with that. And so this year, she just says, I want more. And I says, well, go for it, you know. So
Excellent. She
really does try to get out of the box, think out of the box, and do things with our students. So we're pleased to have her here.
And that's exactly what Foundation looks for when we're doing grants. We look for those innovative grants that we think are going to be something new that the kids are not getting in everyday classes. So congratulations
Thank you once again.
Can I take my check home?
You sure can. Mr. Alexander.
Hey! You got me all right?
Hey! How are you, my friend?
Appreciate it.
Congratulations.
So I get all this good stuff and the balloons, too.
And the balloons.
I want the check, though. That's what I really want.
Congratulations. That's what? $3,900.
Yeah. I appreciate that. Thank y'all. Thank you so very much. We'll put this to really good use, like ASAP. So we've been working on this probably since the spring semester. One of my teachers, Ms. Mendez, that came to me and said, Mr. Alexander, we got a great initiative that we really want to start, and it's called Osmos. I never heard of Osmos. So when she came to me, she showed me the technology, the new device that we already have iPads already. It was just an additional component that we can add to the kids. And then when I start looking at the puzzle pieces, it has numbers, it has the math, you know, and then it has incorporates the letters, it has sounds. The kids actually have to look at the pictures to be able to explain and be able to build their pieces together. The kids all love games, so it was a really great opportunity for our kids, and I really appreciate my kindergarten teachers coming together and working on this collaboration with us. So I really want to thank the city of Waco, the Waco Education Foundation, and of course Waco ISD. So I'm very proud to be part of Waco ISD. Thank you.
Congratulations, Des.
Well, Ms. Clem and your musical group, that's very nice. We want to take a little break here. We have a surprise for you. We're with the Waco ISD Education Foundation, and you are a grant winner for us on our prize patrol this year. $5,000 we're giving to you and your musicians.
Thank you so much.
You
that's
want to tell
awesome.
Us a little bit about this, about what you're going to use the grant for?
Sure. So what we want is for private lessons for students to be able to learn the music for all region and for solo and ensemble to be able to get to that higher level, those that can't afford private lessons on their own. So this is going to be great. It's going to help these students to get where they're going.
Well, it's courtesy of the Education Foundation, and Billy Martin from Alan Samuels Fiat here is the sponsor of this grant. It's a name grant in their honor. And Billy, you have anything you'd like to say?
Just congratulations, and I know a lot of hard work and effort. I have a son that teaches and coaches and is in his profession for 14 years, so we thank you for everything that you bring to us here.
All right, very good. And congratulations, musicians. $5,000 from the Education Foundation to fund creative learning opportunities, which you are providing. We appreciate you so much, and we appreciate all your musicians for doing such a great job. Thank you all. We got big plans for all of you, I'm sure, right? Okay, and your music today, beautiful. We couldn't be more impressed. So this money will go to good use, Valerie.
Yes, thank you so much.
Okay. Hi, Carmen Logan. I'm Jim Patton with the Waco Education Foundation.
Hey.
How are you? Come with me. We want to give you a grant for $7,460.
Thank you so much. We threw my recycling away.
In conjunction with Cargill for your PBLs, your problem-based learning.
Awesome.
Could you tell us a little bit about what you're going to do with the money?
I'm very passionate about project-based learning and just making learning relevant for students. And so I have several teachers on staff who have already bought in. They've already been trying it, but just want more training to be able to just further spread that on our campus to get students involved and also involve our community as well.
Fantastic. Stephanie?
Yes, so as Cargill, we're proud that we'd be a part of the Waco Education Foundation and be able to be here today to present this grant to you. So Cargill firmly believes in supporting our communities and the youth and education, so congratulations.
Thank you so much. Appreciate it.
So you'll be getting information in May, get started, and we look forward to coming back and seeing some really cool projects going on.
Awesome. Good to see it.
Congratulations. Miss Oliver?
Hi.
Hi. I am Jim Patton with Education Foundation.
Oh my
gosh. Yeah. Come on in. You are our next prize patrol winner.
Oh, awesome.
Yeah. Did you know what you wanted?
You wrote a grant and you've been funded $7,200 for Oso Osmo. In conjunction with HEB and Bill Davenport is here, and he'll say a few words. But first, tell us what you're going to do with this grant.
Well, our initiative for Bell's Hill is technology. We just got iPads not too long ago, this year. And so I had seen a program for Osmo. And I thought, oh, this will be great for the younger kids to build and to integrate with reading. And mm-hmm. So I was like, perfect. This gives me a reason to write a grant. So.
Well, and what a grant it is, $7,200.
That's so exciting. Thank you, Ms. Kirkert, Ms. Oliver.
Oh, absolutely. Mr. Davenport, let me get around here. Talk to us about what HEB and the relationship with Waco ISD means to you guys. Y'all have been so supportive of us in the past.
Well, you know, we at HEB, really, we stand for two primary things. And the first one is education. And the second one is everybody to eat well, okay? And so we are just thrilled every year that we get to spend with these kids and all the different initiatives that we do with WISD. WISD is an absolute pleasure to work with every year. Ms. Oliver, congratulations to you. Well written grant, okay? Kids, is this okay with y'all?
Yeah! Yeah.
Congratulations, okay?
Awesome.
So, thank y'all for allowing us to participate. We appreciate it very much, okay?
Congratulations.
With me that also wanted to recognize you, Miss Oliver. Amber, if you will, there.
So beautiful. Thank you so much, Miss right. Amber.
Okay. Thank you, Ms. Fatman. I appreciate it.
Education Foundation likes to do grants that allow creative ideas into classrooms in situations where it might not otherwise happen. And this is going to be a perfect example of creativity impacting student learning. Miss Micus? Hi. Miss Micus, I'm Jim Patton with Education Foundation. Hi, friend. And we are here to present you with a check. You wrote a grant, and we are so thrilled to be able to give it to you. It's the bakery shop.
Yes.
You want to tell us a little bit about it? Just swing around here.
I just think it will be great for my students. It will teach them a lot of functional skills that they need and social skills that they need. And we're just going to run a bakery shop, and I'm just thrilled, and I'm so happy. I'm just kind of speechless right now.
Oh, that's okay. That's okay. I mean, it was one of the most creative grants that we read, and we were so thrilled to be able to help bring this about.
Well, I thank you so much. It's going to help us with learn a lot of skills that they'll need.
Fantastic.
When they go out later on in life. So.
Fantastic. And this grant was also made... made possible in part by Baylor University.
Okay.
So we just want to make sure that we mention them.
Okay.
But
okay.
We understand that you have a fantastic classroom.
Okay,
and this is going to be a lot of fun for your kids.
Yes, it will.
We're
yes,
excited will. To be a okay. part of that as well.
Okay, well, thank you so much.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Okay. Surprise! Hi, Doctor.
Hey.
Well, you brought a crowd.
Yes, we did.
Dr. Kane, a grant from Education Foundation.
Wow.
In the amount of $5,000. Might want
wow.
to turn it around.
Yes.
This is going to summer internships within the city of Waco.
Oh, we need those.
And Donna McKethan had written the grant, and it's... partially funded by Central National Bank.
Oh, what generous donors we have, and all the people who supported the celebrity chef and
Absolutely.
Helped and donated money. This is so important. You know, we have a lot of kids who need to do internships, but they're not all paid.
Right.
And it means a big difference, not just because a little bit of money kind of shows you how much more you appreciate the job, but it's more meaningful whenever you're trying to get a job later on to be able to say, I had a paid internship. So this money is going to be duplicated and tripled and everything else just because Ms. McKethan did such a good job of writing the grant and putting it exactly where it needs. So thank you very much.
Congratulations.
Thank you. Thank you. Section.
We have one more grant.
Oh my gosh.
And Woo! This is This is a $7,500 grant.
Wow. Yay.
Congratulations, Chief.
For artists in residence. And this is Jim Smith from Educators Credit Union.
Thank you.
Thank you.
So
Well, we're just thrilled to be a part of this, as always, and so pleased that it's going to go to something that's going to be so worthwhile. Excellent. And we're excited about the possibility for the students and everything else that it involves. So,
thank you very much.
So, Mr. Carpenter, can you tell us what this grant entails?
Well, this was born out of an idea from a long time ago and still in the classroom. And bringing artists in to bring unique experiences to our kids. Particularly, this started for our three campuses where we don't have a visual arts teacher. So it kind of was born under that idea of bringing in that visual arts for them. But then, as I've been researching, I'm going to try to bring in some performance artists and some dance artists and those kinds of things. Hit some of those fine arts teaks that we don't get to have on a daily basis necessarily. So I'm really excited about the opportunity and lining up some of our guest artists for some of our schools.
So. What will be some of the schools that will be involved in this grant?
Brook Avenue, West Avenue, Provident Heights are the primary areas. We have music at all those campuses, but just trying to add some additional pieces to the
extra
puzzle.
Extra opportunities
for the kids.
Well, on behalf of Education Foundation, spend the money well.
We will spend it wisely.
Yay!
Thank you. And on behalf of Education Foundation, I'm Jim Patton. We've had a great day on our prize patrol. A lot of money's been given out, approximately about $100,000. And it is this community that has come together and is helping Waco ISD students achieve. Thank you so much.
And let's hear it for Jim Patton.